Welcome to EdTech Tuesday. I'm Rich Dixon.
And I'm Jennifer Gibson.
All right, Jennifer, we have an app called Eat-And-Move. Tell me all
about
it.
That's right. This is a great app for health. It is free, and it's really about getting students to realize the foods they eat and the calorie intake versus what it takes to burn off those calories. So why don't you go ahead and open it up?
Interesting. I'll go ahead and launch that.
Let's just take a moment here as it opens up. This is really about learning how to make healthier choices and movement and making that a lifestyle. So go ahead and push play now. All right, so let's talk about eating first of all. So go ahead and choose something in the spinner that you might eat, like that Lunchables seem to be really popular with the kids. Again, I would say this goes up probably through middle school, just to kind of show and have students become aware. All right, so what are you gonna have?
All right, in this case, it says a lunch snack of pizza, cookies, and punch, one package of that. And that is roughly equivalent, it looks like, to 480 calories coming into the body.
Okay, so now on this side, if you're resting, how long is it going to take you to burn that many calories?
Okay, so the equivalent here, it looks like if I'm just resting, 6 hours and 40 minutes, as in sleeping or nap or something.
Okay, try something else.
Yeah, let's try something like homework. It looks like 5 hours and 20 minutes.
Okay.
But let's see what happens when we add some activity into it.
All
like
right.
Dancing.
Okay.
An hour and 44 minutes.
But you have to still realize as a student that you had that snack pack, a Lunchable, and this is an hour and 44 minutes of dancing and moving. And I'm going to go ahead, and I think what I love about this is just bringing up that awareness. I'm going to scroll through here. This is a popular after-school snack for some students, and that's a soda and some chips. Doesn't seem like it's that big of a deal.
1,366 calories. Jennifer, that's a lot.
I have to admit that I've had that as a snack here and there. I had no idea it was that many calories. And so let's say, you know, I'm going to go do some roller sports.
All right. And we can see how long it takes to burn off those calories. I think what's interesting here, Jennifer, is as our country, from time to time, we see it in news about childhood obesity and trying to tackle that. I think what's interesting about this app is it really makes it more concrete in terms of the amount of food
and the
that
awareness.
We eat, what it takes to burn off that.
Right.
That amount. And of course, you know, there's extremes, not eating enough as well, and that can be a concern for some student populations
right.
as well. But
and
I
look
think
at
this is great.
Trampoline. I know that I feel like I'm getting a great workout on a trampoline, but I'm going to have to jump for
seven hours.
21 minutes.
Sometimes the classroom feels like jumping on a trampoline for that
right.
long, doesn't it?
So now as we move around, we can start to look at some of these, you know, healthier choices, like a protein shake, 150 calories, a lot less. Maybe you're going to go help with mowing the lawn. 30 minutes and you've burned that off.
Well, Jennifer, tell me some pros and cons that you see.
Well, this app is really what you see. There's not a whole lot more. So I see this being about a one-time shot. You have a health class. You're talking about calories. You're talking about health and eating and exercise. And so this might be that great way to bring up awareness.
Well, and the cost again on this
is
free. So you really can't go wrong. Even if it's only for a single
right.
lesson, you're not burning through if you happen to have vouchers to purchase apps or you're paying for it with your own money. You don't have to worry about that. It's free. So
and I mean,
great.
I know for me as an adult, just seeing this brought my awareness up about what I'm eating and how much time it takes to burn off those calories. I found as an adult, so I would even say after, you know, talking this through today, that even some high school students would benefit from it. And maybe even bringing it as a homework assignment, taking it home, sharing it with parents, talking to them about their habits of eating and maybe doing a write-up on it afterwards. But I think that you would build the curriculum around this app.
Okay, and so again, this app is free. It's called Eat and Move. Anything else you want to say?
No, I think that's it.